The Tracoe Twist Plus P-tubes are pre-mounted on a minimally traumatic insertion system. For the placement of the tube, a silicone sleeve compensates the gap in diameter between the inserter and the tube tip. The sleeve is attached at the guiding catheter. For the Tracoe Twist Plus P-tubes, the expert dilator and guiding catheter are removed after the tracheotomy, so that only the guide wire remains in the patient. Introduce the insertion system with the Twist Plus tube with pre-mounted guiding catheter onto the guide wire. Bring the tip of the insertion system to skin level using the safety stopper of the guiding catheter. Visualize the mark at the end of the guide wire. Pinch the guide wire with guiding catheter at the end of the insertion system into the notch provided. Start the insertion vertically and place the tube in a controlled movement until the neck flange reaches skin level. Hold the neck flange with two fingers and remove the inserter, guiding catheter, and Zeldinger guide wire. While pulling the insertion system out, the silicone sleeve automatically flips over and can therefore be removed. Inflate the cuff of the tracheostomy tube, disconnect the ventilation tube from the ET tube, and attach it to the 15mm connector of the already situated, non-fenestrated inner cannula. The position of the tracheostomy tube is confirmed via the ventilatory circuit using a fiber optic camera. In addition, another fiber optic assessment is carried out via the ET tube. If necessary, correct the position of the tracheostomy tube during the checkups. The cuff of the ET tube is then deflated, withdrawn, and removed under control of the anatomical structures. The ventilation parameters must then be adjusted. Place a dressing under the neck flange and fix the tube in place with the neck strap. Now the cuff pressure should be checked, for example with the aid of a handheld manometer. This should be between 20 and 30 centimeters of water. Alternatively, our Tracoe Smart Cuff Manager can be connected for continuous monitoring and regulation of the recommended cuff pressure.